Hey guys, today we're going to talk about different types of shifters available in modern trucks and pros and cons of each. Here we are in a newer generation Dodge Ram, and you can see that it has the gear selector over here. The gear selector will only change gear if I have the motor running, but I do have the ignition on right now. So this makes a lot of sense in a lot of ways because we don't grab this all the time. So you put in a gear, we were able to open up tons of space over here for storage because we don't have the gear selector here anymore. There are a couple things though I don't like about this. At first glance, you don't know if you want to switch gears to hold the gear. It's not obvious where it is. It's actually here on the steering wheel. Once you get used to it, it's not an issue afterwards. It is quite convenient just having your thumb there. What I don't like is, I guess I'm kind of old school where I prefer, when it comes to the powertrain, I like as many mechanical things as possible as opposed to electronic. I haven't seen anything really go wrong with these besides they had a recall on it, but over time, when people log on mileage, I haven't seen anything wrong, so I can't knock it for that, but I prefer things mechanical. So that's really the only thing. The other biggest thing that I find is an issue is if the vehicle were to lose power, let's say at a dead battery for whatever reason, or someone hooked up the jumper leads backwards and blew a fusible link, how do you change this to neutral to tow it or to put it on a flat deck? Well, actually over here, you have to remove this panel. So you can see there's a panel right here and you have to take this off. Doesn't seem like a big deal. However, the problem is there's no place for you to put your fingers. You're gonna have to use some sort of pry tool. Now I was using mine and this is used for, you usually use it for woodworking to remove templates off each other. This is actually came from the aircraft industry. That's where it finds its roots. And I had a little bit of a hard time taking it out. It didn't just pop off, which is what you want, because let's say you're going down a logging truck road, you don't want this panel just to pop off. However, if you don't have a tool like this that's wide, you can't distribute your force to take off the panel. So what most people are going to do is they're going to take a screwdriver, which will work. However, a lot of people, if they don't have experience taking off panels, they're going to damage this area just to put this vehicle into neutral. Here we are in a fully loaded F-150 and it has the center console shifter. Now I can kind of see why they lean towards this way, because they're trying to probably hit a market where they are trying to hit a more car-like feel, which I understand. It feels natural just like a car. I'm not really into these things though. The main reason is because it compromises too much. Like if you look here, you don't shift that often if you think about it. And this could be better utilized for using storage. Like, yes, the push button's over here, so by moving it over here, it's a lot easier to use. They do have the gear shifter here. This is good for downshifting. If you want to hold the gear when you're towing or hauling on a grade, that's great. And I'm glad they use just the tip of it, not the whole thing. So it does make sense for certain customers. But I really think when you're driving the vehicle and you are just driving for hours on end, you're not utilizing this at all. It's just sitting there. So I think it'd be better utilized for using this area for storage, because we've taken up this center area. Half of it is just for the shifter. We are now here in my 2005 Chevy Silverado, and it's just that classic column shifter. Now, other manufacturers still use the column shifter. This is a 2017 Chevy Heavy Duty. Here's Ford's version of the column shift, and again, pretty much out of the way. The only downside I can see to this is the gear shift, you have to memorize where it is. You can't actually really see it if you're in gear, if you're driving from the seating position. So even if I were to put it into gear here, I can't see this without actually coming off to the side. So you have to memorize it by feel, which isn't a bad thing. You should be memorizing a lot of things by feel and paying more attention to the road. But I would give that points. I would deduct points for that just because we can't see it. But we can see the tow haul in the sport mode here easily when we're shifted into gear. This is a 2017 Ram. You can see we have the 4x4 selector over here instead. Well, this version has a column shifter. So this is a mid-grade model. and we have a bench seat with a center console over here instead. And this is one I prefer. Like, I prefer it because I'm used to it. You know, you just reverse, neutral, and then drive. And then, okay, if you need to hit, get rid of overdrive, just go to drive, down one, second gear, and then first. Very simple. Tow haul mode is over here. Even if they had the gear selector, I could still see it on this particular one. Whether you have the center console all the way up to the dash, or if you have the bench seat like I do, this works every time. Over here, if it's in gear, it's out of the way. It might be in the way, I guess you could say, of your HVAC controls. I've never really had an issue with it. It's never really bothered me, but I guess you could argue that it might be in some people's way. This is very simple. It's a direct connection to the transmission, whether the batteries off or on. This style or the console shifter are easy to put into neutral, even if your battery were to die or if you were broken down the road, not an issue. But yeah, like, I prefer the column. I've been raised with them. All our vehicles have always had them. I actually like the look. I think it looks very truckish. Looks kind of old school, but that's just my preference. What do you guys prefer? Would you prefer it like this? Do you prefer the one in the center console? Or do you prefer the knob? Comment below. I'd like to know.
If you like today's content, make sure to check out my channel and hit the subscribe button and make sure to hit that bell notification. What that does is it makes sure that you're always kept up to date with all the content that we're providing with you guys on YouTube. So the way that we have the channel set up is I have the uploads up top. That way, at all times, you can always see, if you just hop by the channel, what our latest upload is. Plus, with the bell notification, you're going to get some sort of message from YouTube itself. We also have popular uploads, car videos, how-to videos, demonstration and informational videos, and a lot of cool other specific car videos like our builds playlist. I really like the builds playlist because it takes all the theories from our how-to section, and it keeps applying it to different vehicles.